Hi guys, I know you've been waiting for this moment for a long time. I promised to show you how to create water shader in Blender Eevee. Sit back and relax, then I'm gonna show you some tips and tricks on how to make your water shader look real. Here's my first shader applied to a basic UV sphere. Let me show you around real quick. I just press space to start an animation sequence, and now you can see how water texture is flowing over the mesh. So let's go step by step. So the first thing you need to get right is an environment around your object. Water is very reflective, and we need to have something around to be reflected, right? In this scene, my water bowl is reflecting the sky environment with the sunlight and some clouds. Now, everything you see here is procedural, and if you take a closer look, it's also playing clouds animation. I'll make another video how to create skies like that, but for now, just keep in mind that the world around is very important for water to look natural. Now I'll go to a settings panel right here. You might want to enable these. Bloom to have your specular highlights look real bright, and screen space reflections, which is crucial for water shader to reflect the world around. I'll open this panel so you can see my config. I also have refraction turned on so water can refract everything what's behind it. Another important setting is hidden deep in material properties, so I'll switch here and scroll way down to a settings panel. Here we have alpha blend mode, which should be set to alpha blend. Shadow mode to known because it's a water and we don't want any shadows. Show backface tick should be turned off because it will mess up your depth of field effect. And you should turn on screen space refraction to enable refractions for this particular material. So it's two places where you need to enable that. Okay, finally let's go and see what we have inside. Basically, water shader is just a reflective and fully transparent material with its bump texture animated. If I turn off my bump node here, you can see it's just a mirror ball. Now all the magic is in the texture that we feed to this bump node. Here I'm blending mass grave noise with a Voronoi texture. This way I get something that's closely resembling moving waves. Now see this purple field? This is how I animate the transition of both noise textures. It's called Python drivers, and you can use them to calculate any field value from some basic expressions involving this frame variable. It doesn't matter if your animation is 100 frames long or 2000, one simple expression calculates new value for each frame. Very handy and lets you avoid tweaking of animation curves. But that's not all. Using bump is not enough to make waves look realistic. We also need to apply some displacement. Otherwise, whole water surface will look just flat. Now, here's the real problem. You can't use texture nodes in Eevee to recreate the same stuff for displacement channel. But good thing we have an ocean modifier, which can generate that texture for us. So if I go to modifiers panel here, you can see I have an ocean modifier assigned. It's less than stack, and above it I have some subsurface modifiers to increase poly count. Displacement looks better if you have a denser mesh. However, there is one major limitation of that modifier. It displaces mesh only by z-axis, and I haven't found a way to go around this limitation just yet. But it works for most cases just fine. Okay, now water is not always crystal clear, and sometimes it's all murky and barely passing any light through. How can we replicate it in an Eevee? Answer is to use Volumetric's effect. Here I have a second version of my shader, which has a volume absorption node connected in. Now, funny thing about volumetrics is that by default they create a boxy shape around your object. This is okay if your water domain is rectangular, but what happens if you apply it to a sphere like this? Let me show you. Here I have a special node setup that controls density of that volume absorption node. Look what happens if I disconnect it. We get that boxy volume domain back. I'm sure there must be a better way how you can map density to any shape. If you know one, just let me know in the comments below. Now, final concept which is very important to explain is how transparent shaders are blending refractions in Eevee. Let's create a sphere object behind that big chunk of water so we can see it refracting through. Now, in shader settings, we have two parameters, transmission and alpha transparency. Refractions show up through transmission, and volumetrics show up only through alpha transparency. So if you want to have both effects visible, you need to find the right balance between these two values. If you set alpha transparency to 1, you won't see any volumetrics through. Somehow alpha does not produce refraction effect, it just shows all objects true as is. So I wouldn't recommend setting it to a very low value, or you just see everything behind without any refraction. That's why here I have transparency set to 0.8 and transmission to 1. And if you have transmission at 0, you won't see any refractions. Now there you go, I hope you found this useful. And as always, have a nice day, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.